Let's have a look at how you can put together this navigation menu for your model-driven app. Exactly the same thing if you're doing it in Dynamics 365. This one is a more comprehensive example, but in each case, what we're working with here is groups where you can put a heading in, and then we can add different components underneath. These can be tables in your apps or things like dashboard components. And you can also have a thing at the bottom here, which allows you to switch to different areas in the app. Let's build this together. I'm starting as I always do in my solution, and I'm assuming here you've already built out all of your tables and the other components that you need for your app. This is the last step in putting it all together. Now, what we're actually doing here is building both the sitemap and the model-driven app at the same time. So we've done all of these tables, and inside the solution, we're going to go into here and say new app, model-driven app. From here, we give the app a name. I'm just adding demo to mine so I don't confuse it with the one that's already there that I showed you before. And then we're given this prompt here to start adding pages to the navigation menu. What I want you to do here is choose all of the different tables that you want to add into your app. Now, there are two components, two things we're doing here. First of all, we're creating the app itself, which is bringing all of those tables into the app. And we're also creating the sitemap, or that navigation menu down the side. And they are two different things. You don't necessarily want every single thing that's in your app to appear on the menu. Maybe you do, but not always. You might have tables that sit there underneath that you don't need to click through from the main menu. So I'm going to do this in two parts so that you see how that works. First of all, we're going to click next here, and then we're going to choose all of the different tables that we've got in here. First thing we've got here is a search box. So if I wanted to add to the contact table, for instance, I can simply type that and check it and add it to my app. However, there's a good little shortcut here. If you've built everything inside your solution and with a certain publisher code, what you'll find is that you've got this prefix. Now, I'm working with the sample apps here, so we've got this prefix called sample, but whatever that is for you, if I go in here and search for that, and that might be more likely a three-letter prefix for you, you'll find all of the things that are in that app that you've built. So I can go in and choose those. Now, there are multiple things in here for some of these other apps that I'm not using with this one, so I'm going to choose the ones that apply. Once I've chosen those, just pause for a second here. Do not get too far ahead of me. This button here, Show in Navigation, I want you to uncheck that. The reason for that is, as I said, I'm separating out the creation of the app from the creation of the navigation menu. And the experience of creating the menu is that if at that point you say Show in Navigation, it just dumps them all there in alphabetical order. And the experience of moving them up and down and grouping them, I find more annoying than just going in and building out that menu. I'll show you that as we go along here. So now what we've got is our app, and we've got all of these different things in. Key thing to note here, when I'm here, this is my app and the pages and tables that are in my app. One level down here, this is my navigation menu, and you'll see so far there's nothing in the navigation menu. So just to be clear, what's in the app, what's in the navigation menu, two different things. So what I want to do now is start adding things, and you'll see the preview coming up here of that navigation as we start to build it. So I'm going to click here, and the first thing I want to do is add a group, and I can give the group a name. So as I've got that selected here, here is the properties over on the right hand side. So this title is going to be innovation, and you'll see that change over on the side here, but notice it doesn't appear there. Don't panic, that's because we haven't actually put anything underneath it. So the first sub area here that I wanna add is the challenges. So over the right-hand side here, I can select the content type. It's going to be a table. Select the table that I wanna work with. So we'll just type that in to make it a bit easier. Challenge. Oh, did you see as soon as I did that? Now it's starting to pick up. I don't want to call it sub area one, so we're going to call that one challenges. Typically we'll put the plural in there, and then we are looking good. Let's just give that a save, and you'll see now it's starting to build out. Let's add some more things under there. The next thing we want to do is get that ideas one in there. So what I can do here is add again from that navigation part. I'm going to add a sub area, and I'm going to choose same experience we just did. This is slightly easier now because it will put the name in for you. So this time I want to choose that table called idea. You'll see it puts the title in. We click add, and that will pop in there. And finally, let's add one more in here, which is another table. This time we're going to put in the team projects. All right, so far so good. Now, what if I want other groups and sections in here? I can choose a new group. Let's call this one dashboards. Again, it's not appearing there, don't panic. And I'm going to add something different this time. So I'm going to add a sub area, and instead of choosing table, I'm going to choose dashboard. Now I'm not going to go through all of these other things, but you can also add custom pages. Check out my video on that if you don't know what those are about, as well as web resources and URLs, which are a bit beyond what most model-driven app makers will do to start with. So let's choose a dashboard here. I've got a dashboard that's in my app, so we can choose that. We pop that in and that's there. Now, in terms of moving things around, if I click on this section here, I can move that whole section up and that will take that piece with it. This is what I was talking about before though. If you want to move things up and down, this is the way it's done. So I can choose to say, let's move that down or move that up. If I move it up, another one from here, it'll jump up into the next section or move down again. So if you imagine, if you have like 30 or 40 tables and you put them all in the navigation to start with, this is where I find that moving them up and down through that process, to me, not as intuitive as building out that navigation separately. And as I said, also separating out what's in your app, what tables are sitting in the app by definition, versus the tables that are sitting in the navigation menu. Now, if you want to add that area switcher at the bottom to put something else in there, we can do that as well. So again, we can go in here and you'll see that area isn't an option in there. There's one more thing that we need to do here, which is to click on this navigation bar and see what happened on the right over here. So this is giving us some options: show home, show recent, show pinned. Those are those three things there. So if we didn't want, for instance, pinned records, there we go, it's gone. I quite like pinned records. Enable collapsible groups is a good one because that enables you to do this where you can shrink those things up or down. Maybe, maybe not. And then enable areas will now activate that option. And so now I can go in here and say, let's add an area. So areas are good for things where you might want, say, an administrative type experience in here. So let's put this one in and call this one admin. And you want to make sure you give the original one a name, because you'll see as soon as we added areas, it popped that one in up there. So we don't want to call things area one. So let's just call that one innovation. So then with my admin, I can add same concept. I can go in here and add a group. So let's call this one administration. And again, still not appearing anywhere, still not appearing anywhere there, because it doesn't come up until I've actually added a thing. I've been caught by this so many times, is why I keep emphasizing it. Let's add a sub area in there. Also, just make sure you're highlighted in the right place as you do this. So we're going to put a table in here. Let's bring in the list of users who are in the application. Might be a useful thing for the admin to have. And boom, as soon as I've done that, now I've got a preview and I've got that admin in there, and I can switch back into that innovation area and see all of that going on. All right, we're good to go. Stick with me. I'm going to show you how and where you can edit this. So we're going to save that, publish it, and then play it. And there we go. There's our app. We've got the dashboards. We've got the innovation challenges. You'll see that I switched off the ability to collapse those menus. And there is my area switcher down the bottom to get to that admin experience. Now, if you want to go back and edit this, once you're back in your solution now, we will see that what this has done is created these two objects in here. So we have a model-driven app and a sitemap. Now you might find some older videos that talk about the sitemap and show you a different experience for editing it, but now we can edit these things as the same thing. So rather than clicking through here and editing that, which will take you back into that old experience, which is quite jarring if you're working here, what you want to do is actually edit the model-driven app object. So you just basically ignore that sitemap object now. So if we click edit, that will take you straight back into here. And from here, we can do all the editing. Don't forget, that's where you need to click on that navigation menu, and then you've got everything that you just worked with there. If you'd like to learn more about how to build model-driven apps, check out this playlist here. Thanks for watching.